There she is. Vamos. Bienvenida, señorita Verdugo.
Nos da mucho gusto tener entre nosotros.
Muchas gracias.
That's enough. No more, please. No more. No more pictures.
Who's he? Personal manager.
Pobrecita mía. Me he preocupado tanto por ti.
Sí, Sarita. Hello, Kenneth.
Hello, Linda. These past few months haven't been easy for your sister. She really missed you.
Did she?
Bienvenida, señorita Sarita. Welcome home, señor Kenneth.
Hello, Roberto.
Words can't express the sorrow that's deep in the heart of all of us. When I first came to Mexico over a year ago, I was a stranger in your land. A man welcomed me here with a warmth and sincerity that I have never known, but one that I'm sure you're all familiar with. Ricardo Manuel Verdugo was a kind and generous man. To those of you who served him, were fortunate enough to share each day of his life, take peace in the knowledge that he is in the hands of God. And for the two daughters of Ricardo Manuel Verdugo, Sarita and Linda, the only two people left on this earth to carry on the heritage of this great man. The two who loved him more than life itself.
No, no, I killed him. I killed him.
Thank you.
Roberto, see that the gates are kept locked. I don't want to see any police or reporters in this property.
Sí, señorita.
I'm not a cripple.
Qué saludable está Juanita.
Why must it always be so cold in this house? Roberto! Maria!
Now, Linda, we're home and we can talk.
What were you trying to do? Suppose the reporters were not my friends. What then? Do you realize what the publicity would have done to me? To all of us! I killed him, she said. I killed him!
I should have stayed with him. I should never have left him alone. I did kill him.
Roberto, don't stand there. Put some wood in the fireplace. Now, Linda, let's hear no more of this. You were not to blame. And what do you want, Maria?
You called.
I called Roberto.
Forgive me, Senora.
Sarita, none of this has been easy for any of us. I think what we need is a good drink.
Forgive me, darling. I know how difficult this has been for you. But Father had a good long life. Didn't he? And for that we have to be grateful.
Sarita, I...
No, no, no. Not another word. I'm home now, and we are together. And for that we have to be thankful. Soon you must return to your studies.
No.
Yes. There is nothing more to keep you here. Don't you see?
Here we are.
She doesn't drink. Linda! I don't understand her. She's acting so strange.
Well, she's upset. She's still a child, and she was very close to her father.
You know, Ken, from now on, I am going to be close to her. She needs me.
You miss him, don't you? I want the keys to the convertible, Roberto.
They are in my pocket, señorita. If I put this down, I would only have to pick them up again.
Thank you, Roberto.
Thank you.
es que vengo pena. Me voy a la orilla al mar a preguntarle a las que han visto a mi amor pasar. Cada vez que tengo pena, me voy a la orilla al mar a preguntarle a las olas si han visto a mi amor pasar.
You know that you shouldn't be here. You're supposed to be in mourning.
I've been in mourning all my life. And to you, Michael.
Saw you at the airport. You look beautiful.
I saw you too. And you know what I wished? I wished you and I could get on that plane and fly away from here forever. Let me stay with you. Don't make me go back. I'm so afraid of that house. Please, please, Michael. You've got to let me stay with you.
Oh, come on, honey.
La cucaracha ya no puede caminar porque le falta marihuana que fumar.
Michael, she hasn't changed. I don't think she even cares that father's dead. Sometimes I think I hate her. Sometimes I know I do. Michael, please. You've got to let me stay with you.
Hey, calm down. You're with me now. Come on. There's nothing that can stop us. Not Sarita, not anybody.
Please, tell me. Tell me how much you love me.
Again.
Again and again and again. Show me how much you love me.
One of these days, I'm gonna kill him.
What is wrong with that dog, Roberto? Why does he cry like that?
He knows. He knows something. And I know something about you, Chiquita.
Oh, please, Maria, wondering where I have gone.
The hell with Maria. She's an old woman. I would not be surprised. You would not give her a tooth to be where you are right now, sweetheart.
My, such a man.
You do not know it yet, but that is the truest thing you have yet said. Yes? What is it now?
Roberto!
Yeah?
Tell Juana to come here at once. Do you hear me?
I am sure they can hear you in Canada. Old woman.
I must go.
Hey, Juana!
Hear the dog? I suppose you forgot to feed him again. Is that it?
No, no, Maria. I tried to feed him before we went to the cemetery. And again after supper, but he wouldn't touch his food. I swear it.
Well, we cannot hear this yowling all night through, can we?
In the house. I'll feed the dog.
Roberto!
He would not eat, senorita.
You leave Duque alone. Leave him alone.
Oh, senorita. The keys.
Mira, Roberto. My father is dead. I can come and go just as I please. I don't want you to ever forget that.
Naturally, senorita. Good night.
Where were you, Linda? I said, where were you, Linda?
I went for a ride. I had to get away, Sara. So I went for a ride.
A dónde fuiste, Linda?
A dónde fuiste? What did you do? Who did you see? You say that you love me. That you want to be near me. To help me. Well, Sara, you helped me all right. You held me 4 months ago. When you send me home from that prison, you call a school. When you send me home to take care of Father. Because I found something in those flora. Something I had never had before.
Oh, you found something? And what did you find, Linda?
Freedom. Freedom from you.
How can you say such a thing? How can you even say such a thing? I give you whatever you want. I give you clothes, I give you food, I give you everything.
And confinement, no? First, it was the convent. Then, the girls' academy. All my life was spent locked up because of you. But then you would call that protection.
You're a foolish girl, a young girl.
Look at me, Sara. Do I look like a young girl? I am a woman, Sara, whether you like it or not. I am a woman.
You are 20 years old, and you will not have your freedom until you are ready for it.
And when, big sister, will that be? When you die?
Your father wept today. You stood there and cried. And yet you cannot wait to leave his home. Why, Linda? Why?
This wasn't his home, Sara. This is your home, your furniture. Everything is yours, Sara. Everything. But me. You bought my clothes and my food. Yes, but you did not buy my soul.
Oh, Linda, you know, I will die before I hurt you.
No, Sara. I have lived in my sister's shadow for as long as I'm going to.
Linda. Linda! Linda!
Time, Señorita Sarita. And it's dark and windy out there.
Maria's right, Sarita. The dog didn't know you. You're a stranger in your own house. You see? He's all right now.
Beyond me that you walk this trail every single day.
Well, it's something one gets used to.
Mm-hmm.
If you work with sheep, you must climb like sheep.
The day the man fell through the railing there, you were right here?
As always, sir.
And aside from the airplane, did you hear anything else when he fell?
I only heard the bell.
Then there was nothing different about this day. As usual, he came out to the arches and...
Wait.
Yes?
The woman was not with him.
Uh-huh.
And he was always with women.
Uh-huh. So he was alone this time?
Yes, sir, he was alone.
I see. All right, thank you. Inspector?
Good morning, Roberto. It's a long way down, isn't it?
Yes, but it's a longer way up.
I thought your work was done here, Inspector.
You know, when a man dies accidentally, there is nothing for the police to do.
I was thinking the same thing.
I'm sure you were. Tell me, these arches by Señor Verdugo?
There is nothing around this place he didn't build. But with Sarita Verdugo's money.
I see.
Anything else, Señor Davis?
No, Juana. That'll be all for now. Thank you.
Juana, ayúdame. Anda, pronto, pronto.
Ah, two beautiful women. Sarita, you feeling better this morning?
Much better, thank
Good.
You.
Look. You know, I'd almost forgotten how beautiful it is here. It's been a long time.
Yes. The day looks almost too perfect. What's that?
DeVargo. He's happily agreed to all your terms. No fittings, no dresses.
It's about time. I thank Carmen 100 times.
Well, he signed the contract.
I was hoping he misplaced it, Kenneth. I don't feel like singing.
Oh, no, no, Sarita.
Not this soon.
You know as well as I do, you're not happy unless you're on the stage. And if you're not happy, my dear, we're not happy. And you have to pay the servant.
Well, it looks like I want to sing again.
I am very happy to hear that. Very happy indeed. I am sorry to bother you at such an early hour. I am Inspector Valdez, the police. And you, of course, a Sarita Verdugo. Your sister, Linda. And Mr. Davis, your personal manager.
Well, Inspector, then you know who we are.
It is my business to know, Senora.
There is a very high wall around this place, an iron gate, and all for one purpose.
I apologize for the intrusion, Senora. I will not bother you for long.
I'm afraid it's quite impossible, Inspector. You see, Senorita Verdugo is due at the Opera House.
So you are in a hurry, of course. You know, I love opera, but especially Sarita Verdugo. And I am very pleased to hear that you are going to sing again in Mexico.
That's correct, Inspector.
Now, if you'll excuse us, Inspector.
Yes, Mr. Davis, but I would like to have a word with Linda.
Un momento, Inspector. My sister has told the police everything she knows.
Then she will not mind telling her story once again. Just so that we may close the case. All right? Linda, please don't be afraid. Just tell me in your own words exactly what happened on the morning your father died.
It was the shopping day, and everyone was in town. I pushed my father out to the pavilion just like always. And while I was there, I heard the phone ring in the house. Ahorita vengo, papá. There was no one to answer it, so I ran back. But when I got there, the phone had stopped ringing.
Bueno? ¿Quién?
I started to leave.
Bueno?
Someone spoke to me, but I could not hear very well.
heard the bells ringing. I ran outside. And the bells were ringing. And below, Duque was lying there. And there was the hole in the railing, and Father was gone.
A terrible thing.
Now, Inspector, if you are quite finished.
Yes, I am finished. By the way, who called you on the telephone, Linda?
I don't know. It was the wrong number.
Mm-hmm. Well, that happens sometimes. Señorita Verdugo, Linda.
Goodbye, Inspector.
Goodbye, Mr. Davis.
Say, we're going to be late. We don't want to make DeVargo more nervous than he is already.
You're right. It will be a good idea to get out for a while. Linda will go with us. You have nothing planned for, have you, darling?
No, nothing.
Sarita, darling! Sarita, welcome, my dear. Welcome.
DeVargo, you will never change. You're still the same.
Mr. Davis. Senorita Linda, how are you?
DeVargo, I don't want to touch a sore spot, but is this place going to be ready for the opening?
Guru, we're ready. When the Sarita Verdugo, the una prima donna of Mexico City, is going to sing? When the entire opera house is already sold out? Hey, yeah, my friend. We will be ready. Sure, we will be ready.
Gracias. Muchas gracias. ¿Qué te puedo decir? Gracias.
Sarita, una foto, por favor.
Miren, I want to tell you something. I cannot sing today. You know why? My father was buried yesterday. You know how I feel. But I would love to sing anything you ask me, because you are my friend.
Pero les voy a decir una cosa. No crean que me olvido de cuando empecé, cuando no era estrella, sino cuando era una partitura. ¿Y sabe cuándo? La primera vez que entré, nunca se me olvidaba. Estaba tan nerviosa, que un día, en lugar de ponerme los zapatos, que eran dos zapatos verdes, me puse uno rojo y uno verde. Y como entré, y la señora, que además era la de él, me dijo, ¿y esto? Y además se le olvidó el área. Ahí empecé a ser estrella. Porque las estrellas no se les debe olvidar, porque no tiene un zapato verde y uno rojo.
Look out, Gallo!
I'm gonna tell you one thing, Inspector, and it is the truth. Señor Verdugo was not a noble man, and he was not a kind, generous father. He was a drunk.
Those are very strong words, Roberto.
4 years. 4 years I've been here. And almost never did I see him sober. Sick and shaken? Yes. Almost falling out of his wheelchair? Yes. But not sober. Mm-mm.
You know, no one has mentioned this before.
Huh? Who would mention such a thing? Huh?
You are right. Yet, one cannot help but wonder why a man would drink like that.
For one reason. To forget. A man drinks that way, to forget.
You can close your investigation right now, Inspector, because I can tell you exactly what happened to Señor Verdugo.
That is something I have not been able to figure out for myself.
Oh. I show you. The day came when he could no longer forget. He pushed himself off the pavilion and dropped down into the ravine.
Mm-hmm. You sound almost as if you had seen it happen, Roberto.
Oh, no. I didn't see it happen. But would you bet anything against what I have said?
No, my friend, I would not. Can you tell me, is this phone connected with the house?
No.
It is mine. I use it to order supplies and food.
So you could ring the house from here?
No. For inside communication, I use a talking box.
I see.
Sarita, how can you say you are not going to zinc? One man makes a mistake. Créame, por favor. It was an accident. Sarita, my workmen insist that every rope was secure.
But was not secure enough.
I'm sorry. I'm truly, truly sorry, Sarita.
I'm sorry. I'm truly, truly sorry. Is that the only word you have to say?
What more can I say? It was an unfortunate accident.
All right. It was an accident. But I could still be dead. And that would be tragic. Because I mean so much.
Sarita, you mean a great deal to all of us.
Bah, don't give me that. Your first concern is my voice. You don't give a damn about me. The only thing you care about is this throat. And if you could, you would squeeze the last penny out of it. You would! Huh. Sarita Verdugo. She means nothing to you. But Sarita Verdugo's voice, well, that's a different story, isn't it? Because it means everything. Because it means money! Money, that's all!
No, Sarita! No.
And why are you all staring at me like that? Do you think I'm crazy? Is that it? Well, I am not crazy. It is just that I can see. Now, all of you, please, leave me alone!
Sarita.
Oh.
Linda, help your sister to her room.
You're right, Ken. I'm a little tired.
Señor Davis, please. Please, explain to her. She must know my great love and concern.
Vargo, you've known Sarita a lot longer than I have.
Oh, I don't know, honey. Forgive me. I don't know why I say such a thing. You know, Linda, everything I have is yours.
Yes, Sara.
Oh, my head. Oh, please help me. I'm so glad that you're here. You know, Linda, look. Oh, Linda, I want to talk to you. Linda, stay with me for a while. Quiero decirte muchas cosas. Muchas cosas quiero decirte. Muchas cosas.
Climbed the mountain for a woman before.
Your hand.
Oh, it's only a scratch. I can't think tonight. You know why?
I've got the most beautiful job.
How wonderful, Michael.
From Acapulco to California and back again.
What?
On the SS Italia.
SS Italia?
Hmm. I'll be singing in the boat, and many important people will hear me. It's going to be a very big break.
It means I will be away from you.
No.
I will not let you go.
I've got to. It means money for you and me.
You're not going, Michael. You don't have to go. Michael, we can get money. Lots of money.
Oh, sure, sure.
When Sarita is dead, it's mine. All of it is mine. Do you know what I'm saying, Michael? It's our money.
Now, look, Linda, I didn't mean to say anything.
Everything's out there waiting for us, Michael. A whole world of Acapulco, Rio, Riviera. Remember, darling? Oh, Michael, will you help me? Please.
If I stay, will you do exactly as I say?
Yes.
You know, once we start, we can't go back.
Yes, Michael. I know.
Okay. I will do it for you.
Not for me. For us.
Go back to the house. I have to think. We will do it.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
I was looking for the cigar box.
We're all through with that. Don't you understand?
Well, it worked all right with the old man, so I thought we'd try it again with Sarita.
You leave that to me. You just keep making love to Linda.
Listen, it's been 3 months.
You listen. You listen to me. There's $1 million in that house. $1 million in cash when it's all settled. And nobody's gonna rush me out of that. Do I make myself clear?
Yes. But I hope it's not 3 more months. I don't even like her.
Oh, Mike, we're getting closer. Mike, once there were 3 little Verdugos, huh? Now there are only 2. Soon.
Yeah, but when?
Just leave everything to me. You take care of your part of the deal. And I'll take care of my...
Okay.
Now you better get out of here.
Chicken.
nice, Doc. You don't have to worry about. You have had this before, haven't you?
Huh? Roberto? What do you want with a chicken?
I'm going to show you how to become a millionaire, sweetheart.
A millionaire?
Well, very rich anyway.
I do not know what about Roberto.
There is a saying, my dove, that says, never look a gift chicken in the mouth. Huh?
You mean a horse?
Right now, I mean a chicken. Come over here. The old man die?
No.
I do.
We all know what happened last night. Sneaking in this property like a common thief. Answer me.
I love him, and he loves me.
He loves you. He loves me. Honey. Linda, are you blind? He loves you. You know why he loves you? Because you have money. That's why.
It's not true.
Darling, you're still young. You must be patient. And in time, the right love will come. That. And then, that love, you will be proud of it.
And what do you know about love, Sarita?
So that's it, huh? You think I have never loved? All my life, I have been busy taking care of you, Linda.
Then you will be happy, because soon you will not have to worry about me anymore.
No, 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 Linda. You know, after the opera, things will be different. You know, I want you to leave school. You hear that? And then we will travel. To visit places you never dream of. And then you might meet a man. The kind of man father will be very proud for you to marry.
Sarita, you can't promise her that. You've got commitments.
To hell with the commitment. Por favor, Linda. Linda, tell me, you will come with me?
All right. After the opera, I'll do anything you say. Will you take me to Acapulco?
Claro que sí, of course.
To Rio, the French Riviera?
Yes.
Good, because that is where I want to go.
Oh, Senor Davis.
Roberto, are the keys in the other car?
You will not be using the limousine?
No, we'll use this.
Oh, that's too bad.
Why do you say that?
Looks good, eh? It shines like how you say? Like $1 million?
Yeah, it shines like, how you say, $1 million.
Ah, sí, seguro.
What's on your mind, Roberto?
Oh, nothing at all. Except if this whole car shines like $1 million, surely this little fender, such a small part of a car, surely shines like $50,000, huh?
And why should one little fender be so valuable, Roberto?
I don't know. Perhaps because I see so many strange things in it. Would you believe that on the night the old man died, I saw a boy, the one you were with last night. He was carrying a cigar box right here on this property.
Cigar box?
Mm-hmm.
What the hell are you talking about?
And that same boy buried the cigar box right here. You see, Mr. Davies, I'm not a rich man. I'm not a rich man at all. I'm sure you would be happy to give me $50,000 for finding the cigar box, huh?
You know, Roberto, I like you very much. You're a nice young fella.
Thank you.
But if you want to live a little longer, you better behave.
Perhaps Inspector Valdez or Señorita Verdugo will appreciate very much that information.
All right, 5,000 tonight.
And the rest?
In 2 weeks.
Thank you, senor.
Stupid fool.
What's wrong?
Roberto found the cigar box.
He found what? What are we going to do?
You're going to give him $5,000 tonight. And you make sure he doesn't get a chance to use it. You understand?
And aside from the rubber marks made by the wheelchair, that is all I can find.
Then you cannot tell me if the hairs of the dog were caught in the wood before or after the railing was broken.
Well, if I could tell you that, I would make my living with a crystal ball, Inspector.
Mm-hmm.
But if I were to make a guess, I would say that some of the hair was caught before, and some of it was caught after the board was broken.
Thank you, Ortiz. Well, Elena?
Linda Luisa Verdugo was born in Switzerland. Lucerne, Switzerland.
I see.
Senora Verdugo, she died 30 minutes after the child was born.
Mm.
Our records show that her husband Ramon and a servant named Maria were by her side when she passed away.
Maria, huh? Thank you. See? Yes, this is he. Uh-huh. How much money? Are you sure? And all that money goes to Sarita? I see. Thank you. Tell me, Elena, if you were expecting to inherit one half of $1 million, and instead somebody else got it all, how would you feel?
Well, I would be very angry.
And what would you do?
I would cry.
Oh?
I always cry when I get angry.
Of course.
So Miss Sarita said to me, Roberto, see that the dog is fed and keep him quiet. And I said to her, yes, he's disturbing people.
But he does make too much noise, especially at 3 o'clock in the morning. He bothers me.
He bothers you, huh? But not like I bothers you, eh, chiquita? Now for a little siesta,
Oh, I do not like to sleep so early in the afternoon.
Why? But it is good for you, sweetheart.
Oh, come on, sweetheart. Don't be like that.
Well, why not?
Well, you don't have to worry about Maria. And you can bring some more beer and listen to the radio. And last and best of all, you got me. Roberto Ortega.
I think I go to work.
I think I'm gonna get you some more beer.
Better hurry back. I don't have all day for you.
I am running my sleep. Excuse me.
Ay, mamacita, ahorita contigo. Boy.
Well, I've got the money. Where's the box?
Why, not so quickly. Yeah, it's all here.
Come on, let's have it.
You're in such a hurry. You must have more work tonight, huh? You young people are always in a hurry. You know, one must take his time in business and in pleasure. Yeah, don't you think so?
I'll be right back. What about the money?
You will have to trust me, as I trust you, boy.
I am waiting.
Oh, you are beautiful. Here, take this.
What are you doing?
Oh, nothing. I'll be right back.
Where are you going?
I have to see Duke. I don't want him making too much noise.
What's the matter, boy? Eh?
Smile. You're paying a small price for the most expensive cigar box in all of Mexico. Huh? How do you like that? Come on. Now, let's see. Where did I put it?
There he is. It's all yours. You dare your little hand. I'll get it. Boy.
No.
How's that, boy?
Roberto? Roberto? Roberto, is that you?
Face it, Sarita. They love you. They worry about you.
Oh, Kenneth. I'm so nervous. Something's going to happen. I can feel it. Oh,
come on, Sarita. Don't be ridiculous. You and your premonitions. Here, come on. Take this a little
bit. No, I don't want it. What did all have to happen? I was so happy in Europe.
Yes, we were, weren't we, Sarita?
Kenneth, I need you.
Well, I'm still here.
I need you, Ken.
I am afraid I have bad news for you, Señorita Verdugo.
What do you mean you have bad news for me? Why is it that every time we meet, you have bad news for me? Why must you always be bothering me, Inspector?
There has been an accident, Señorita Verdugo. Your dog has killed Roberto.
Roberto! ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué, Luli? ¿Por qué me pasa eso? Dígamelo, ¿por qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué, Roberto? ¿Por qué? ¿Por qué?
Find anything, Inspector?
Hello, Mr. Davis. ¿Encontró algo?
Aquí hay algo interesante, Inspector.
Déjame ver.
Good news?
In a way, it's not good news at all. Can you read Spanish, Mr. Davis? This is a report from the laboratory. They performed an autopsy on the dog. They found nothing. But I suppose a dog would do such a thing to a man if he hated him enough. And as you know, Roberto and the dog were not exactly on the best of terms. But that's the way it goes.
Well, yeah, I guess that's the way it goes, Inspector.
Off again?
If you need me for anything, I'll be up at the house.
Fine, but we will talk again, huh?
Oh, of course, Inspector. Any time at all. Any time at all.
Oh, excuse me. Don't worry. It's not a dog, I'm sure. Well, he didn't give up his life easily, did he?
No, he did not.
It's very strange, Ortiz. Most strange. A dog that suddenly becomes so vicious he can kill a man. And just as suddenly becomes as gentle as a kitten. Why, Ortiz, why?
A drug, perhaps.
A drug that leaves no trace in the system. You know, my feelings are that I should have another talk with Sarita Verdugo. Yes. I must keep a closer watch on her, our little star of the opera.
Opening without rain.
Don't worry, darling. By tomorrow night, the rain will stop. The theater will be packed with people. Sarita Verdugo will sing, and the audience will stand and shout, "Bravo, Sarita, bravo."
You know you're right. The applause and cheers. That's all that seems to matter. And after that, what?
Darling, have you ever thought about retiring, quitting the opera, and settling down?
Yes. But I like it too much to spoil our relationship.
What exactly is our relationship?
What is it, Ken?
I asked you first. Darling, don't you realize that I love you?
I love you too.
Well, if you really do, why won't you marry?
She needs me.
I need you too.
Thank you. But life's not that simple. I never been happy. I never have love. I am only a marionette. Star, Sarita Verdugo. Always surrounded by people, by admirers, with everything, money, but always alone. With only one thing in my mind, my father and Linda. I gave them everything, but I never have time to be close to them. And now again, she needs me. I'm sorry, Ken. Talking about.
Sara, I'm leaving now.
Why?
I'm being married tonight.
No, Linda.
And there's nothing you can do to stop me.
Linda. Listen to me, Linda. You cannot get married. You know nothing of men. You don't even know that boy.
I think I do. Goodbye, Sara.
No, Linda. Linda. You cannot leave me. Listen, Linda, you cannot leave me. Oh, you see, I've been working all this year. I want you to be hurt because I don't want you to pay for that pain. Linda, listen to me, Linda.
Goodbye, Maria.
Por la vía de nuestros padres. Father was not proud of me. He was ashamed. You know why? Because I had a baby. My sister. Linda, look at me. I am your mother, Linda.
Liar.
Linda! I am your mother.
Liar!
Por favor, Maria. Tell her. Tell her mother, please, Maria. And can stop her, please stop her.
It's too late, Sarita.
I'm afraid something may happen to her.
Don't worry, Maria.
I'm going to call the police.
No, no. I'll go after her.
Thank you.
Sari. Sari.
Llévensela. You said she was running out in the street like a mad woman.
Si, senor. I saw her crash her car, and I followed her to help. But she just ran.
It's too bad.
Can I do anything else for you?
No, thank you. I'll call you later.
Señor detective, ¿era Sarita Verdugo?
Si, hijito, si. Era Sarita Verdugo.
Señorita Verdugo.
Do you want me to go with you? Thank you.
I hate to rush things, but I should be at the airport an hour before the flight.
Don't worry. We still have plenty of time. I'll be back in an hour.
Linda. Linda, my loss is as great as yours, believe me. I loved Sarita very much. Goodbye, my dear. Oh, Linda, you're going to make a beautiful bride.
How'd we do, huh, partner?
I've got to hand it to you.
You'll hand it to me, all right. A check every month. Don't let me wait too long, understand, Mike? I want to give you a friendly little reminder. There are only two people in this world who know that you killed Verdugo and Roberto.
The police killed Sarita for us.
Ironic, isn't it?
You know, I never thought that the police would make me rich.
Yeah, well, I think the Mexico City Police Force deserve a friendly little salute.
Something wrong, officer?
Nothing is wrong, senores. Everything is fine. Thank you, Ortiz.
No!